Okay, welcome back guys. I hope you all doing good, and I also hope that you have seen the course content 2, that is about the designing procedure and the governing equations. It was a quite lengthy video, that's why I split it into 2 points, and I'm making the course content 2.1. And in this we are actually going to select a particular problem statement, and we are going to plot a constraint diagram. So, but before that, I want you to see one constraint diagram so that you'll get an idea of what exactly it is. So let's have a look at it. Now here it is an example of a constraint diagram. Now in the constraint diagram, we are actually plotting on the y-axis the thrust by weight ratio, and on the x-axis we have the wing loading. So after plotting, and we have several graphs on this thing. So what are these things? So the first line, this line tells you the curve of Vmax, that is the maximum velocity constraint that you have for your plane. Then you have the STO, you can see STO. So this is the STO, means that the takeoff distance. So you have, let's suppose you have a constraint of takeoff distance, that your plane should take off in, let's say, 20 meter, 50 meter, 40 meter. I'm talking about RC planes. Okay, so in how much distance your plane should take off, that constraint will met by this line. Then this line, and again this above region, not the region below. So this is above region. Then the stall condition. Then in the stall condition, we will see that what will be this stall condition curve is a straight line. So basically, it is independent of the thrust by weight ratio. So it is a straight line like this. So it is independent of thrust by weight ratio. Now after that, there are another constraints such as rate of climb. That after how much distance your plane should lift at that point. See, this is the rate of climb. So this slope is nothing but the rate of climb. Then the ceiling height. These many ceiling heights means at maximum what height your plane should fly. So ceiling height is this h1, h2, h3. So from the ground, at what height your plane should fly, that is that constraint is made by this line, the line of hc, that is this one. This line. So these are the constraints that are going to decide what your plane will have as a wing loading as well as the thrust by weight ratio. And the design point is the one, here, here, or here. In this design acceptable region, we'll select a point which is going to give you the optimum design for certain thing. So optimum design, I mean, if I want strictly that stall speed, strictly I want that maximum velocity, then we'll select a point which is going to give more optimistic result in that case. So this is our design. We'll define an acceptable region, and in that acceptable region, we're actually going to design our plane. So that's how the constraint diagram works. So it gives you a complete bounded solution of all the points that will give you the same result, and that will be according to your requirements. So this is basically the heart of the designing procedure for any aircraft. Now let's move on to a problem statement and draw a constraint diagram for it. So this is our problem statement. Now we are going to design an aircraft which is an all up weight of 2 kg, then it can fly with a cruising speed of 15 meter per second, and it can take off within a 40 meters. So these are the objectives that I want to see in my plane. And next to that, we have an objective for the size as well. So the constraint for the size is the wingspan of the aircraft should not be greater than 1.2 meters. So these are the constraints for my aircraft. Now the majority design constraints that are with the object oriented to the purpose or the mission of the aircraft are this, that is the 2 kg all up weight, cruising speed 15 meter per second and a takeoff distance of 40 meter. So what I need to do is I need to plot 3 curves or 2 curves in my constraint diagram. That is first for the cruising speed and second one for the takeoff distance. So these 2 curves I need to plot in my constraint diagram. So for that I need to see the particular equations of these lines in the constraint diagram from my reference. So these are the equations I need to look for my this one and this one. These equations I need to look for my purpose. Now I'll open my references and see these equations. Now this is the equation for cruise. If you want me to explain every term for it, I would like you to give me a like and a comment in my box so that I could explain you how I decided these parameters, how I found out these values. Actually, all these things are mentioned in the reference. So I thought if you could go through the reference, it will be better because you will understand the thorough procedure, because I have told you the thorough procedure. And if you went through this, you will get to know it more better. Then these are the conditions from which I have plotted my constraint diagram. And to plot the constraint diagrams, the Excel comes into the picture.